It's time to free up some space from your phone because I'm going to tell you some very cool and useful Android apps. So let's get started. Okay, so the first app in our list is the volume lock app, and it basically makes the volume button useless. Once you set it up, no one will be able to increase or decrease your phone's volume. This is pretty useful in situations where kids take your phone for playing games and they just put it on silent mode so that the incoming calls or notifications can go unnoticed and they can continue to play for as long as they want. But not anymore. Just turn off the respect sound mode in the app and you're set. You can even password protect this app so that the smart kid can't get to it. Now, if you're someone who starts to get motion sickness the moment you start looking at your phone in a car or bus, then this app is for you. It basically creates a horizon level like this on your phone screen that moves with the car, which surprisingly helps a lot in reducing the sickness. Now, it's not some random going on here. In fact, the app actually synchronizes our inner ears with our eyes with the help of this liquid-like horizon level, and this just works. It's so useful that even Apple has introduced this feature in iOS 18. It's not just iPhone that copies Android. Android does it too, and this app is a very good example of that. This app brings iPhone standby mode to Android and tries to do it better with more customization options. It turns your phone into a smart display when it's on charge and placed horizontally, so you can use it as a bedside clock, a photo frame, or a display with multiple widgets. You also get a ton of customization options with colors, font styles, frequency, and whatnot. It's completely free with ads, but you can buy the pro version for getting rid of the ads and ability to use the app in portrait mode. Thank God for that. This app turns the punch hole into an action button, and that can do multiple tasks with just gestures. For example, I can single tap to get to the top of the page, double tap to take a screenshot, long touch to open the app, swipe left for the previous song, and swipe right for the match. Swipe right for the song. This is quite cool, isn't it? Now, I can assign any of these actions to these 5 gestures and they work flawlessly. Some actions are free, and for some, you need to buy the pro version, which isn't very pricey though. Now, if you're someone who just can't concentrate on studying or working and watch a lot of YouTube videos like you're doing right now, I can see you. Then you need to get this app. This is LearnOS, and it's basically a launcher that locks you in a controlled environment for a set duration so that you don't get distracted by your phone. You can write your goal here, record a motivation voice note, set the duration, and select the essential apps for studying, and just enter the tapasya mode. Now, you won't be able to access the apps that waste your time in the tapasya mode and can concentrate fully, but if you want to exit before the time ends, the app tries to make it difficult by putting out some puzzles or math questions, and it also plays the motivational message that you yourself recorded while entering into it. If you have trouble sleeping at night, open a book and start reading. For most people, that'll do the trick. But if you don't like that idea, you need to get this app. This app has a wide variety of ambient music, animal sounds, nature, cityscape, and more that helps you relax and sleep. On top of that, it's completely free, the UI is pretty good, and there are no ads or subscription to poke you. Whenever I'm spending a lot of time watching reels or reading manga, this app reminds me that I need to get back to work by showing me this picture of myself. Mindly tracks the time you're spending on any app, and if you're wasting too much time on your phone, it will show you your own photo or a cool GIF. Whatever. You can even customize this to something you fear, like your girlfriend or your wife. Now, this app will only notify you, and if you wish to ignore that, you can continue with your scrolling. But if you want something even more strict, you can go with the Stop Scroll app. With this app, you can set a timer on YouTube Shorts, IG Reels, or even Snapchat Spotlight videos, and once your daily quota is over, you will still be able to open the app, but you won't be able to access these addictive vertical videos that is probably deeper than the sea. There's also a block mode that completely blocks these short form videos. You'll still be able to watch the long form YouTube videos like this one, or see images on Instagram, but won't be able to access Shorts and Reels. This is what the comment section looks like whenever we show this app in our videos. The app that I'm talking about is the OG media player, Poweramp. There are two big reasons I personally stick to it. The UI, it's very cool even in 2024. Look at all the animations when you move between different sections. And secondly, you get a lot of control on audio. You get a full 32-band equalizer, and you even get this preset EQ for any of your audio products. There's a lot more to this app, so try it out. So that's it from my side. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Press that like button if you want us to make more videos like this one, and let's hang out in the comment section and get to know each other. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.